the other game and nil all in this game. And Didi, it's not the goal fest that we maybe thought it was going to be or hoped it was going to be, I should say. Why not?
Not yet. Hopefully we see some in the second half. Colombia just got bullied by Senegal's pace, physicality and aggression. They couldn't get 2-3 passes together. Very aggressive Senegal, by far the better side. Couldn't really open Colombia up. But they just couldn't live with him. And I was quite surprised because Colombia is a team, they can look after themselves. But they seem to be surprised by the physicality Senegal gave them. And at no point you felt they're going to create a chance here. And then with Rodriguez coming off, certainly didn't help. And I think if the other game stays as it is, I think Colombia's got a mountain to climb to win that game.
They do. And Kevin, you know, before the game we were saying James Rodriguez, what a big shout he's going to have in this game. Yeah. That's a huge disappointment for Colombia.
It is. You know, he wasn't playing well before that anyway, but it's a big disappointment. Depends how bad it is. You know, it could be their last game anyway, so they won't need him. But they never got into it. It's like they used up all their zip and their energy in that polling game. The second half of that polling game, they were so good. They've just not brought that today to the first half. They've had no rhythm. They've had nothing. You know, we wanted to pull out a clip or two to show at halftime of them attacking, and we couldn't find anything. There was an offside for Falcao header and a free kick from outside the box. You know, it was just nothing for us to talk about. It's been disappointing. But on top of that, Senegal have been excellent. You know, they've really been organised. They've made it very difficult. They've worked really hard. You just wonder if they can keep that up in the second half and stop Colombia using that front four and that outnumbering the midfield. Will they be able to keep working that hard to stop them and shut them down like they have done the first half?
It's a balance, Richard, isn't it, between being disappointed by Colombia and really impressed with how Senegal have played?
Yeah, I think tactically Senegal have got a spot on. We think of 4-4-2 as a bit of an attacking formation, but when you have two strikers working as hard as they're two, it really helps the whole team. Colombia haven't been able to get their full-backs forward to create the overload for the midfield three, their star players, and Falcao's been isolated a lot, you know. So tactically, as I say, Senegal have been perfect. They've done it right. But even when they're on the ball, they look more energetic, more hunger to get forward and to score goals, and they've completely shut up shop. And Colombia have really struggled in that first half, and they need to find something from somewhere. They're missing a star man now, so they need someone else to step up and start creating something, because at the moment they're causing no trouble whatsoever for Senegal.